Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At this, the Jews there began to grumble about him because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." They said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How can he now say, 'I came down from heaven'?" "Stop grumbling among yourselves," Jesus answered. "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws them. And I will raise them up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They will all be taught by God.' Everyone who has heard the Father and learned from him comes to me. No one has seen the Father except the one who is from God. Only he has seen the Father. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in my sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. A life of faith can be tough. We all have moments when we feel as if we're at the end of our rope. Doubt and obstacles can come thick and fast. Faith is a journey with many steep hills. But if you want an enriched life, the sort that you were created to live, Jesus leads us into a fullness of life that is unparalleled. How do we find the way? The journey is clearly marked. It all begins in our heart with trust. We were created by God to know him, and he longs to make the journey with us at our side. He truly loves us in a way that's hard to put into the words because it has no equal. He's beyond convention, beyond religion, beyond reason. He's purely love. And as we allow that love to flow over and around and in us, it will wash away the hurt and the pain and the fear. He asks nothing in return, just that we will receive. But he has a purpose for us. We're on a journey, and his love is food for our body, mind, and spirit. Humans need food to exist. One of the most surprising things that Jesus does after resurrection is to eat and drink, revealing his ongoing humanity. When Elijah prepares himself to die under the broom tree, an angel appears offering him cake and water, encouraging him to eat and drink and rest. This is a miracle with a purpose. Only when he speaks for a second time is Elijah able to eat and drink and be sufficiently strengthened to make his journey, 40 days and 40 nights, to the mountain of God at Horeb. I read a childhood story about a king who announced a competition. All the best chefs in his kingdom were to make a signature dish for him. elaborate and fussy confections appeared, until the king was sick of all the rich food that he tasted. Last, he came to a child who had baked a loaf of bread for the king. The king enjoyed that bread so much that he declared the child the winner. It reminded me of I Am Victoria. I don't know whether any of you saw that play during the week, played so powerfully by Saran Jones. She was desperately trying to impress friends and acquaintances by projecting an image of success. She was terrified of failure, setting herself unrealistic goals. And of course, it eventually resulted in a meltdown. We can only do so much in our own strength. I have a quote on my desk. The challenge is to be yourself in a world that is trying to make you like everyone else. So the challenge is to be ourselves. I wonder, do you have a role model? Someone you respect, admire, and want to be like in some way? It might be a famous person, it might be a great athlete. We've seen plenty of them recently. It might be someone you know personally. It could even be your mother, your father, your brother, or your sister. Whether we realise it or not, we all have role models. And it's important that we choose our role models carefully. If we choose a role model just because the person is rich and famous, we're likely to be disappointed. Paul said to the people in the church at Ephesus, "Imitate God in everything you do, because you are his dear children. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. He loved us and offered himself as a sacrifice for us." So what are some of the things about Jesus that make him the perfect role model to follow? Jesus is kind, loving, forgiving, patient, obedient, respectful, and truthful, just to name a few. We could go on and on, couldn't we? Jesus is our perfect role model because he is God's perfect Son who brings salvation to all who follow him. St. Paul encourages tender-heartedness, urging the Christians in Ephesus to be kind to one another. And that kindness becomes something richer when we understand that the Greek word also implies being useful. Christianity is love expressed in action. When Paul urges the Ephesians to be imitators of God, he's commending something not found anywhere else in the Bible. Following God is hardly the same as modelling yourself on God, attempting to copy his characteristics. It is a precious reminder of our calling, our high calling. Our fairy tale sits comfortably beside today's readings, which commend what is wholesome and straightforward, rather than complex and mystifying. In fairy tales, it's fine for one person to win while others lose. Like psalms, they're often told from the point of view of a single individual who faces enemies beyond their apparent strength. Either by noble effort or by supernatural intervention, the individual hero wins through, usually. The story of Christianity is very much not a fairy story, not even one of the morally improving kind. Tucked away in our readings are two clear pointers to the universal nature of God's love for all that he has made. The Father is the enabler who draws people towards Christ, and every person who is so moved by God will come to him. And this teaching absolves us of any guilt at our failures to inspire and convert others, and their failures to repent for themselves. The first task of every Christian is to follow Christ. So let us pray. Lord God, thank you for sending your Son to save us and to be the perfect role model for us to follow. Though others may fail, Jesus never fails. We want to live a life that is pleasing and useful to you, Lord.